Dear students, we shall go to the next topic on Kaplan turbine today, that is the numerical problems now. So in the last class, we were discussing on the components of Kaplan wheel turbine and the working proportions of Kaplan wheel turbine. We shall go ahead with solving the problems and designing the Kaplan turbine for the given data now. So for recapitulating the last thing what we have discussed about the working proportion, if h is the head, n is the rotation of the rotational speed, p is the power developed now, that is the shaft power shp, and d naught is the outer diameter, d naught is the outer diameter of the runner, and db is the hub diameter. If q is the discharge, we know that we found the area of the flow equal to pi by 4 into d naught square minus of db square. What is db here? Db is this one now. This is the diameter of the hub now. It is also called as the boss. It is also called as the boss. And d naught is the outer diameter. So it is flowing from this area. I want to find this area. That will be equal to total this area minus of this area, because this is the diameter of the boss where the water is not flowing. You will get the area of this one now. The velocity of flow will be constant in the Kaplan turbine now. And the peripheral velocity u can be obtained with respective diameters. If you keep the inlet diameter pi d naught n by 60, you will get the value of u1. If you keep the outer diameter, you will get d naught n by 60 now. So the discharge through the turbine by using is found by means of using formula pi by 4 into d naught square minus of db square into vf now. Okay, where vf is called as the flow ratio now. Vf is called as the flow ratio, which can be obtained. Kf is called as the flow ratio. Generally, the range of this one is about 0.65 to 0.70 now. And db to d naught, db to d naught is called by a constant called as n, as we discussed as in the Francis turbine. The same thing n is also being discussed here now. So n is equal to diameter of the ratio of diameter to of the boss to outer diameter is called as the n here now. So with this we can solve some problem now. So a Kaplan turbine is generating 60,000 kilowatts. This is nothing but the power. It is given now. And net head of 25 meter. The overall efficiency is 90%. Taking the value of speed ratio Ku. Speed ratio Ku is 1.6 now. Where you will use Ku? U. In the equation U, you can get a Ku into root 2 GH. That you can say. Or u is also equal to pi d naught n by 60. Using this equation also you can obtain. Any one equation you can obtain. The flow ratio phi in some books as well as in some examination they have given psi as the flow ratio. It is also equal to Kf. Kf is equal to psi. Is equal to 0.5. The hub diameter is 0.35. That is db is equal to 0.35 times of d naught. Find the diameter and speed of the turbine. This is what it is being asked now. So these data have been depicted in this slide now. So we know that eta naught is equal to shaft power divided by the water power. That can be obtained P divided by WQH now. So this is being given 60,000 kilowatts kilowatts. So if you use kilowatts in the numerator, then in the denominator you have to use kilonewton here. This should be equal to 9.81 needs to be used. Otherwise 60,000 multiplied by 10 to the power of 3, if you use that in nothing but newton meter per second, then you have to use 9,810 what is being utilized. Okay, so that should be known to you now. So otherwise the answers will become wrong. Now you have got the value of Q now. So Q is equal to pi by 4 into d naught square minus db square into Vf. Now Vf is equal to Kf into root 2 gh. The value of Kf is given to you now. The value of Kf is 0.5, that is being given to you now. This is what we told, the value of Kf. Just substitute that value of Kf. The value of H is given to you. The value of H is 25 meter is given to you. Therefore, you can get the value of D dot, diameter of the outer diameter. When once diameter of outer diameter is obtained, you know that dB is equal to 0.35 times of D naught. You can obtain that also. That is 0.35 times 5.97 will give you the value of dB now. Okay. U is equal to KU into root 2 GH. You can get the value of U now. And U is also equal to pi D naught N by 60. So you can get the value of speed. So you already obtained the value of D naught now. You can get the value of N. So the things that he has asked you in this problem is find the diameter and speed of the turbine. So that means he has asked you diameter D naught and the speed N. What is this? Okay. So however, in this I have already also shown you how to obtain the value of dB also. That can also be obtained by means of obtaining 0.35 times of 5.97. That also you can obtain it. So as the problems goes, you will try to understand how to solve for various parameters now. Very simple problem now. Now this is the second problem now. 22,500 kilowatts power is available now. The head is 20 meter. The speed is 150 rpm. Hydraulic efficiency is 95%. Overall efficiency is 88%. Outer diameter is 4.5 meter and the inner diameter is the 2 meter. Inner diameter is nothing but the diameter of the hub now. What is asked you now? Assuming discharge, turbine discharge without wheel, that is VW2 is equal to 0, determine the runner vane angle. Determine the runner vane angle at hub and at outer periphery. So the vane angles at inner as well as the outer periphery is to be found in this problem now. So therefore you have to solve the velocity triangle now. So these are the data that he has given now. You start with the same procedure what you have obtained. First you get the value of Q by means of using the formula, overall efficiency, shaft power divided by water power, get the value of Q now. Get the value of Q. The value of Q works out to be 130.92. Q is the only unknown here now. Just look into here. Here we have substituted the value in kilowatt. Therefore, the value of 9.81 is also in kilonewton per meter cube. That should be known to you. In the previous problem, we used watts. This was in newton per meter cube we have used now. So you get the value of D naught and dB is obtained. Given now 4.5 and 2 is given in the problem now. 4.5 and 2 is given now. When once these two are given, you can get the value of the Vf now. When once Vf is given, Vf is equal to Vf1 is equal to Vf2, get the value of Ub. That is nothing but inner diameter I have considered. Inner diameter, because we want to find the runner vane angle at inside as well at the outside now. The value of U is 15.7. The value of U is equal to pi D naught N by 60 or pi dB N by 60. So you get it as 15.7 now. Eta H is equal to VW1 u1 by gh, that you got. Work done per unit discharge per second is nothing but vw1 u1 by g, that you know it, and divided by the weight of the water, that is equal to wqh, that will be multiplied by, but that is also per unit weight, per unit discharge, it will become wqh will become h only. Per unit weight, per unit discharge, it will become h. This is the output, this is the input. That is, work done is the output, input is nothing but wqh, we know it. So, but per unit weight, per unit discharge, these two will become 1, then you will get the value of input as 1. Input as h. Input as h now. This is the input now. The output is equal to vw1 u1 by g, because we know that wq into vw1 u1 plus vw2 u2 divided by gh is the formula. So here vw2 is 0, vw1 u1 plus or minus vw2 u2, we were using it, that you know it now, into u. This is nothing but the u, fx, fx into u we were using. Fx is equal to rho AV. So per unit weight means this will become, AV will become 1 now. So rho by g, you will get W is equal to rho by g, you will get the expression for this one now. So you know this expression, how to obtain it. This we have discussed in the very previous classes now. Using this expression, VW1 U1 by GH, we have obtained the value of eta H now. We have obtained the value of eta H. When once eta H is known to you now, you get the value of VW1 from it now. That is the velocity of whirl at this one now. So the velocity of whirl here is 11.87. Therefore, the velocity triangle will be this much now. This is the velocity of the whirl now. This is the speed, peripheral speed now. So the triangle will be like this now. You get this angle now. Get this angle now. The value of theta, 180 minus theta, is nothing but this angle. That angle will be equal to 69.4. That is the runner end angle at the inlet is 110.6. So 69.4 you will get. This angle will be equal to 110.6. That is the runner vane angle at inlet now. So you should be in a position to write the velocity triangle properly, because U is greater than here VW1. Therefore the triangle will be in this pattern now. Okay. Now the next thing is, Here the next thing is, you want to find the value of we were here 110.6 we got it now. Now the outlet triangle VW2 is equal to 0. VW2 is equal to 0, that's what being told now. So VW2 is equal to 0 when it is there now. The outlet triangle is radial. Radial outlet triangle you have to draw. Radial outlet triangle you have to draw. Radial outlet triangle will be in this form now. This is the outlet now. This is VR2. This is VR2. So this is U2 now. The value of U2 is equal to 15.7, that you can see now. This is being found. 15.7 is being found now. So that we have utilized, you got the value of outlet triangle. Okay, you know the value of U2. So you know the value of VR2. You get the value of tan psi. Tan psi is equal to VF2 by U2, because VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to VF. That we know it. We have already calculated it. The value of VF is calculated it. the value of VF is 10.21. This is being already calculated. Therefore, this value is being calculated. So this value is being utilized here. You know the value of VF1. You know the value of U1. Substitute and get the value of sin. So these two things should be known to you. What is the concept you understood now? VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to VF. This is first concept you understood. And you know the value of VW2 is equal to 0. These two concepts you understood in this problem. Okay. So radial outlet means you know it already. VW2 is equal to 0. VW2 is equal to 0. Indirectly he is saying that it is a radial outlet triangle. So we shall go to the vein angle at the extreme edge. Vein angle at the extreme edge. Once again I am coming to the same. This is the, he has asked you to find the value of theta now. So pi d naught n by 60. D naught is equal to 4.5. D naught n is equal to 4.5. That is given now. Just look into here now. 4.5. So you get a value of 35.34 now. At the extreme edge it is now. At the extreme edge, that is the outer periphery now. So eta h is equal to, once again the same principle we are using. Find the value of VW1 now. 5.21. Now just look into here now. U is equal to 35.34. 5.27 now. And you get the value of U minus of VW1. U1 minus of VW1. You will get 18.27. The value of theta is equal to 18.27. That is, this angle will be equal to 161.28 at the extreme edge. At the extreme edge, it is 161.28. At the hub, how the triangle will be? At the hub, the triangle will be like this now. At the outlet also, the triangle will be like this, but the angle is shifting now. That's what we discussed in the Keplon turbine now. The rotational angle, the blade will not be at constant. It will be a shifting type of blade. It is squirrel like that now. So the rotational angle at the inlet, at the outer edge, will be 161.28, but at the inner edge, it is 110.6. That should also be understood in this problem. And at the outer edge, once again, if you look into the outlet triangle, the value of psi will be 16.11 now. The same principle now. The same principle, VF1 is constant now. Velocity of flow is constant. But the value of U1 will be equal to 35.34. The value of V1 is equal to 35.34. That is to be taken and you got it as 16.11. This angle is 16.11. But at the inner edge, how much it is? At the inner edge, it is 33.03. Just look into it. 33.03. So at the hub it is, near the hub it is, but this one near the outer edge now. That means what it is? If this is the hub now, now the blade is like this now. If you think now. At this point, we have calculated. This is the outer edge. At outer edge, the blade is in the configuration of runner vena angle equal to 161.28. That's what we are looking now. At the inner edge, it is at 110.6 degree now. Okay, inner edge means what? At this point, this is the inner edge now. So inner edge and outer edge should be properly understood now. So this is the inner edge. So it has gone now. Just look into here now. This is the hub means. This is the vein means. This is called as the inner edge. This is called as the outer edge. At outer edge, it is 16.11 at outlet and at inlet. This is at outlet and inlet. So the angles is changing. The angle of the veins are changing now. It is not constant. As we see, a constant angle is there. That will not be there in the case of Kaplan turbine. Now we shall go to the next problem now. It will be, we shall see some more problem, then it will be clear to you now. So here, a Kaplan turbine runner is designed to develop 10,000 kilowatts now. The net head is 6 meter. The speed is speed ratio is 2.09. The flow ratio is Kf is equal to 0.68 and Ku is equal to 2.09 and the speed and the shaft power is equal to 10,000 kilowatts. Okay, the overall efficiency is 80%. The diameter of the boss is 1/3 the diameter of the runner. That is dB is equal to 0.33 times D naught. This is what it is given now. Find the diameter of the runner. That is D naught is equal to what? Its speed, N is equal to what? The specific speed, Ns is equal to what? These are the things. So it is an examination problem anyhow. So now, these are the data that are given. Just look into here now. Once again, the same, this one now. So as you know now, U is equal to Ku into root 2 GH. Using this expression, what we have calculated, Ku is given 2.09. We got the value of U now. The value of H is given to you now, 6 meter. The value of H is given to you. You get the value of U. Similarly, you know the value of V of 1 is equal to Kf into root 2 GH. Therefore, you can get the value of V of 1. Okay. And the eta naught is given as previous. You solve the equation. Eta naught is equal to P divided by WQH. Get the value of Q. What is the value of Q now? 10,000 kilowatts he has given now. So I have used here 9.81 because it is in kilowatt now. So you get the discharge as 212.36 meter cube per second now. So get the value of D naught because you know that what is dB is equal to 0.33 times D naught. Substitute it. You will get the value of V of 1 you have calculated in the previous slide now. V of 1 is equal to 7.37. Substitute the value of Vf and get the value of D naught now. And the dB can be obtained now. So the speed U1 is equal to outside diameter is required. So speed is equal to U1 is equal to pi D naught N by 60. You get the value of N now. You have calculated already the value of D naught now and dB. That is the requirement now. And get the value of peripheral velocity at the speed of the turbine by using the formula U is equal to pi D naught N by 60 now. Okay. Or Ns is equal to N root P divided by H to the power of 5 by 4. Using this equation, you can get the value of specific speed. Very simple. Nothing more. So all these equations are known to you now. Substitute one by one, you will get the solutions for the problem. So same type, these two problems have been given now in the examinations. So I have just copied down in January-June 2012 and June-July 2016. You can solve the problem. There is no much this one, just change the number of numbers and get the answers. Nothing much more about it now. So I don't want to repeat the procedure now. We shall go to the next problem now. So the hub diameter of a Keplon turbine under a head of 12 meter, that is equal to H is equal to 12 meter, is 0.35 times the diameter of the rudder. That is dB is equal to 0.35 times D naught. That's what he has given. The turbine is running at a speed of 100 rpm. Okay. If the vane angle of the extreme edge of the runner, extreme edge means outer edge, is 15 degree and the flow ratio is 0.6, Kf is equal to 0.6. Find the diameter of the runner, that is D naught is equal to what? Diameter of the boss, dB is equal to what? And discharge through the runner, Q is equal to what? Okay. Assume the velocity of the wheel at the outside is equal to 0. That is VW2 is equal to 0. That is what he has given now. So it is also an examination problem now. So now, VF1, flow ratio he has given. So VF1 is equal to Kf into root 2 GH. You get the value of VF1. And anyhow, you have to solve the triangle now. VW2 is equal to 0. Therefore, the triangle will be like this. This is for the extreme edge outlet triangle now. I have already told you, this is the boss means, here there is the runner now. This is the boss means, this is the runner now. So I am getting at the outer edge. That means at this point, this velocity triangle is being written here now. So VW2 is equal to 0. Tan psi, just to put here, tan psi is equal to VF2 divided by V2, or V2 is equal to U2 now. Okay. So you will get the value of VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to 9.6. Get the value of U2, because he has given you the value at the outer edge. The outlet angle is 15 degree, he has given now. The extreme edge, the vane angle is nothing but psi is equal to, he has given now. That is equal to 15 degree, he has given now. That is being utilized and I have obtained the value of U2. When once U2 is obtained, you can go for the value of pi d naught n by 60 now. Okay. So pi d naught n, d naught is equal to 6.55. Substitute it, you will get the value of dB now. Okay. Get the value of Q because you know the equation now. Okay. So simple problem now. So he has asked you to find the diameter of the runner, diameter of the boss and discharge through the runner. Not much more than it. You need not have to solve at both the ends the velocity triangle. So in the first problem, we solved the velocity triangle near the hub as well as near the extreme edge. Here he has given you the extreme edge. So I am solving only the extreme edge velocity triangle. So Keplon turbine, next problem we shall go, of runner diameter 4 meter. And the discharge is 60 meter cube per second. The value of Q is 60 meter cube per second. The value of Q is 60 meter cube per second. 1 minute. value of Q is 60 meter per second. Hydraulic and mechanical efficiency are 90% and 94%. That is what is given now. Eta H is equal to 90% and eta naught is equal to 94%. Correct? Correct. And the value of Q is equal to 60 meter cube per second. And the diameter of runner D naught is equal to 4 meter. Okay. The diameter of the boss is 0.3 times the diameter of the runner. That is DB is equal to 0.35 times D naught. That is equal to 0.35 times 4. So whatever you will get it now. That means how much? 4 5 is 20, 4 3 is 12 plus 1.40, I think you will get. Correct? 0.30 times he has given. 0.30, say, very sorry. He has given 0.30 times. So that will become 1.20. Directly we will get 1.20 meter. So 0.30 times the diameter of the runner. The speed ratio is 2. What is this? Ku is equal to 2. Assuming the discharge is free and there is no swirl, that is Vw2 is equal to 0. Calculate the available head. You want to calculate the available head down the turbine, H, and the power developed by the turbine, P is equal to what, and the specific speed, Ns is equal to what. These are the things that is asked. These are the things that we know it now. What is that we have known it now? So this is 0.30. Once again, I will write it. It will be good to you. Otherwise, anyhow, in the next slide, it will be there now. Anyhow, when you look to the problem, you should be in to write the values. That is my this one now. 0.30 times D naught. That is equal to 0.30 times 4. That is equal to 1.20 meters. So that is dB. These are the values that is being given now. One by one, we start solving the problem. The problem will always become easy now. So these are the values that are being given to you now. Just look into here. Q is equal to 60 meter cube per second. D naught is equal to 4. And N is equal to dB by D naught is equal to 3.3. Therefore, you will get 1.2 meter. Eta H, eta M, speed ratio Ku is equal to 2. This is what is given now. So what are the things? DB and D naught is given means you can get the value of Vf directly, because we know that pi by 4 into D naught square minus DB square into Vf now. I can get the value of Vf now. Vf is equal to Vf1 is equal to Vf2 is equal to 5.24 now. So important thing that we want to know here is eta H is equal to output divided by input. So what is this now? Total head minus of the losses that are going to happen, that is V2 square by 2G, that is the output. The remaining head, this is divided by the input, is nothing but H now. So important equation, this one, H minus V2 square by 2G divided by H. How I got now? This amount of energy is being get lost, and the remaining head is total head minus of the lost H, that is the total output divided by the input is H now. So from this I will get the value eta H is equal to H minus of V2 square into H. From this expression, H will go this side, H minus of V2 square by 2G is equal to eta H into H now. So I will take this one, this side. So what you will get now? H into 1 minus of eta H is equal to V2 square by 2G. So H is equal to V2 square by 2G divided by 1 minus of H. This step is very important here now. How we got it now? Okay, H minus of V2 square by 2G is the total work done, or it is nothing but the total energy remaining, H minus of, this is the one that is being utilized by the turbine, H minus of V2 squared by 2G, okay, because V2 is the velocity at the outlet now. So now, you will get the value of H now. When once H is obtained, your work is almost over now. You know this equation, eta naught is equal to eta H into eta M. This we know it, we have already derived. And eta naught is equal to P over WQH. So what you will get now? So I substitute for P is equal to eta naught into WQH now. So P is equal to what? Eta naught into WQH. But eta naught is equal to eta H into eta M. That I substitute here now. So I will get P is equal to eta H into eta M into WQH. You know the value of eta H and eta M, and WQH is also known to you. You will get the answer of in terms of watts because you have used 9810, and that can be converted into kilowatts. The value of power can be converted into kilowatts now. Okay. And U is equal to KU into root 2 GH, that we know it now. So get the value of U. You also know the value of U is equal to pi dN by 60. Get the value of U now. Get the value of N now. So from this expression, because the value of QU is given to you now, what is the value of KU? So here he has given you the speed ratio is 2. Speed ratio is given as 2 now. So if you substitute that, KU is equal to 2, you will get the value of U. Substitute in U is equal to pi dN by 60, you will get the value of N now. So speed is equal to NS is equal to N root P divided by H to the power of 5 by 4. Get the value of specific speed now. All the things is known to you now. N is known to you, P is known to you. Important in this equation, P should always be in terms of kilowatt. That should be there. In specific speed equation, the value of P should always be in terms of kilowatt. So this problem is a little critical for you. You should know the things properly. One is this one, H minus V2 squared by H. How I got now? So this is the total head minus of the energy utilized by the turbine, that will give you the output. This minus of this will give you the output. Okay. So energy totally utilized by the turbine is equal to output divided by the H you will get. So that is the input is equal to eta H. From this expression, you got the value of H. This is one thing that you should know it. The second equation is eta naught is equal to eta naught is equal to eta H into eta M. This we know it. Anyhow, this to be once again resubstituted in this equation. P divided by WQH. So, that I have substituted in this equation. Eta H into eta M into WQH. That will become to get the value of P now. To obtain the value of P now. So, it should be properly understood how to tackle the problem now. Okay. So, indirect method of obtaining the values, what is required for the design, is being understood in this problem now. Okay. Now, one more problem. Keplon turbine 20 meter develops 12,000 kilowatts now. The outer diameter is 3.5 meter. That is, D naught is equal to 3.5 meter. The inner diameter of the hub is 1.75 meter. That means you have to use the value for the Q. Q is equal to pi by 4 into D naught square minus dB square is to be utilized. That should be. The guide blade angle at the extreme edge. Once again, at the extreme edge, the value of alpha is given to you now. Alpha is equal to 35 degrees. The hydraulic and overall efficiency is 88%. Eta H is given 88% and eta not is given, here 84%. If the velocity of whirl at the outlet is 0, that is VW2 is equal to 0, determine the vane angle at outlet and inlet and also the speed of the turbine. That means you want to find the outlet and inlet vane angle. Outlet and inlet vane angle means you have to get the value of theta. Okay. Theta and psi is to be obtained now. Okay, that's what it is being asked. That means you have to solve the velocity triangle. So theta and psi ought to be obtained in this problem, and the value of speed is to be obtained. These are the data that is being given. Alpha given now. I have converted into watts now. Okay, now let's go to the problem now. So in this problem, once again, shaft power divided by water power, the same thing, you get the water power now, WQH, and get the value of Q. Principle is same now, nothing now. And you know the value of Q, get the value of VF1, because you know the value of D0 and DB. D0 and DB is given in the problem. D0 is equal to 3.5 meter, DB is equal to 1.75 meter is given in the problem. Substitute it. You will get the value of VF1 now. You get the value of VF1 now. So when VF1 is equal to VF2 is equal to VF, that you know it now. So get the value of tan alpha directly, no problem. Tan alpha is equal to alpha is equal to 35 degrees is known to you. Get the value of VW1. Okay. So how the triangle will be, just look into here now. So as I told now, work done per unit weight per second is equal to VW1 U1 by G. Per unit weight per unit discharge per second is equal to VW1 U1 by G. And this will be equal to H. WQ will become 1. Per unit weight per unit discharge is equal to Q will become W and Q will become 1. And you will left with H. So this expression will be equal to, this is the eta H equation that you know it now. Eta H, from that you get the value of U1 now. He has given you the value of eta H. You substitute it, the value, and get the value of U1. Get the value of U1. U1 is equal to 12.25. The value of U1 is equal to 12.25. That you know it now, in this expression now. The value of U1 is equal to 12.25, you know. And the value of VW1 is equal to 14.09, you know it. So with these two values, you get the value of theta. What is the value of theta now? Tan theta in this expression is, what is the value of theta now? Just look into here now. Tan theta is equal to VF1 divided by VW1 minus of VW1 minus of U, because VW1 is greater. This is the equation that you will get now, VW1 minus of U. So get the value of theta now. 79.66 now. Okay. Tan phi, anyhow VW2 is equal to 0. Therefore, you will get tan phi directly. Tan phi is equal to VF1 by U2. You substitute it, you will get phi is equal to 39.33 now. Okay. So the speed of the turbine can be obtained. U1 is equal to pi D0 n by 60. Substitute it, you get the value of n now. You get the value of n. N is equal to 68.84 RPM now. Okay. So no much this one now. Principle is same now. You should be in a position to velocity triangle, draw the velocity triangle and solve the problem. Not much problem in there. Try to understand here now. This equation should be properly understood here now, how we got it now. Okay, VW1 U1 by G, this is the work done per unit weight, per unit discharge, per second. Per unit weight per second is equal to WQ is equal to 1, it will become Vw1 u1 by g. Vw2 is equal to 0. Therefore, work done will be equal to Vw1 u1 only will commit. Otherwise, Vw2 u2 will also come into picture. Vw2 u2 will become 0 because Vw2 is equal to 0 in the present problem now. Okay. Now we shall go to this problem. A Kaplan turbine develops 6,500 kilowatts under a head of 6 meter. The velocity of flow is through the runner is Vf is equal to 6.50 meter per second now. The diameter of the boss is dB is equal to 0.35 times D naught. Okay. And the vane tips at an angle have a velocity of u is equal to 22 meter per second. Of course, outside diameter you have to take the overall efficiency is 85%, eta naught is equal to 85%. Determine the diameter and specific speed of the turbine now. Very simple problem, not much things are there now. P is equal to P over WQH, that you know it now. So 6500 he has given now. 6500 kilowatt he has given now. You convert it into watt because I am using 9810, get the value of Q as usual. That thing, no change. The value of eta naught is given to you and the value of H is given to you, 6 meter. Substitute it, you get the value of Q now. So use that Q and get the value of D naught because Vf1, the velocity of flow is given. In the previous problem, velocity of flow was not given. You were getting either D naught and dB. Now here, yes, the velocity of flow is given as 6.50 meter per second. So get the value of D naught and know the relation. You know the relationship between D naught and dB. Get the value of dB now, because dB is equal to 0.35 times D naught. That we know it. Therefore, I substituted. I got the value of dB now. U is equal to pi D naught n by 60. Very important here is at the extreme edge. He has given at the extreme edge is 35 degrees, 1 minute. The vane tips have a velocity of 22 meter per second. That is extreme. You have to think it as extreme edge. That is pi d naught n by 60. Get the value of n now. D naught is equal to 5.38. You know the value of u, 22. N you obtained. Get the value of ns. Ns is equal to n root p root by h to the power of 5. The problems will be very much simple and straightforward. You need not have to worry more about it. You try to solve the problem. I have solved some of the examination problems only to make you comfortable now. So the problems, you understand the problem, understand the concept, try to know which is extreme edge, which is the near the hub, and substitute the values properly and get the value of the parameters, what is required for the problem or what is required for the design now. So here I think we will stop. Here we are completing the problems on the Kaplan turbine. In the next class, we will go to the draft tubes and unit quantities. Thank you.